In this video, we'll be looking at using VTScada ChangeSet files to both distribute and then update a VTScada application. If you're not familiar with VTScada, it's a simple yet powerful SCADA and HMI software which can be used for monitoring systems of any size. If you'd like to learn more about VTScada or the free version VTScada Lite, click the link on the screen to learn more. Getting back to ChangeSets. Using ChangeSet files is the most common way to distribute or update VTScada applications when the server and development computer are not on the same local or wide area network. A ChangeSet file is essentially an entire application in one, typically less than 5 megabyte file. A ChangeSet file does not include the application history or alarm and event databases. It does, however, include all pages, tags, settings, custom images, as well as the application version control history. While I run through the process of creating and applying ChangeSet files, you'll see this text and the background change to indicate if I'm showing work done from the development computer or from the end user computer, which we'll call the primary server. In this case, each computer will be running Windows 10 and each will have VTScada Lite installed. Let's assume that I'm a system integrator. I have just completed the application which is currently on the screen and I wish to push it out to a customer. I'll begin by clicking the application configuration button. It should be noted that this button is only visible to those with sufficient user privileges. Next, I create a ChangeSet file. From here, I'm presented with several options. The first is a ChangeSet. Second, a snapshot file type, which is similar to a ChangeSet, except it does not include the version history with the application. A template file type is outside the scope of this video and is used to create an OEM layer, which can be used to speed and standardize application development. Let's proceed by creating our ChangeSet file by clicking the ChangeSet button and then clicking the Create button. We simply pick our file name and location. Next, we will send this file to the primary server computer. Because the file is just a few megabytes, I can send this file to the primary server by essentially any means, including email. Now we will switch computers to the primary server to add the application there. There are actually two ways to add this application. The easiest is to simply double-click the ChangeSet file. I'll run through the slightly longer method, which uses the Add Application wizard. First, copy the file onto the local machine. Next, click the Add Application button. Click Advanced and Get from ChangeSet. Browse to the file and select it. Click Next. Ensure the Start Application Now button is checked and click Finish. The application should begin to load. Now we see the application has been added to the computer. Next, let's go back to the development computer and simulate a customer requested change to our application. We will use the Idea Studio to make our change. At super speed, I'll add a couple slider widgets to change the high and low alarm set points. Now that we have our application updated, we'll make another change set, this time Rev2, using the same process as before and again sending it to the primary server computer. With the new version of our application on the primary server, we will go into the application configuration settings. Note that on my application, this will require supervisor privileges. This time, we will click the Apply ChangeSet File tab and click Select. We navigate to our latest ChangeSet file and click Open. That's it. Our application has been updated and this didn't cause any interruption to the running application. Thanks for watching this video on ChangeSet files. If you'd like to learn more about these files, please click the link shown in the video to be taken to the online VTScada help files.